Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So here in Utah last night we had a nice little snowstorm and I was thinking I want to see what happens when I put snow in a vacuum chamber. So let's grab a little bit off my truck here. Let's go throw it in and see what happens. So here's my vacuum chamber. You can see the tray of desiccant in the back there. I'm just going to set this snow onto some cardboard, just like that. Alright. And now, let's suck out the air. Alright, so it's been a few minutes. The pump has quieted down. And you look at the snow here. Doesn't look like it's changed a whole lot. Or at all. You still see the flakes there. I might get the macro lens here in a little while and see if I can see that a little bit better. But you'll notice that the cardboard is not wet. Like, it's been long enough, the room's warm enough that the snow should have melted a little. And yet, you see no liquid soaking into the cardboard. That actually makes a lot of sense because the pressure in there is too low for liquid water to form. In fact, if the snow melts, it should go directly from a solid to a gas, or sublimate, much like dry ice. In fact, I suppose this would be dry ice. Just not frozen CO2. Now, I'll tell you what, I'm gonna switch out the lenses and get a nice close-up shot. Then I'm gonna get a heat lamp and put it up against the glass here and see if we can cause that snow to melt or at least sublimate faster. Okay, so it's probably about as good as I can do. You can see the snowflakes a little bit. They're all kind of jumbled. And that's what happens to snow when it piles up. You see like little needles of ice crystals in there. All right, so the image is a little dark because I had to turn down the aperture size. That's not going to be a problem here in a second when I turn on the heating lamp. Ah yes, that is substantially brighter. And I think I actually saw a flake move over there. Let's pull the camera back just slightly and go back to where we were. I'll just focus it a little bit. There we go. So most of the energy from this lamp will be stopped by the glass, but some of it should be absorbed into the cardboard, I think. Yes. We are melting the snow. Let's watch this for a little while. Let me move the lamp a little closer. There we go. So yeah, the infrared light is blocked by the glass, but the visible light can get through and warm up the cardboard. And of course the infrared light will be re-radiated by the glass once it warms up enough. Look at that, you're watching snow melt in a vacuum chamber. You notice there's no liquid being formed. It's just kind of disappearing. It's turning to a gas and probably being absorbed into my desiccant or winding up in the vacuum pump oil. Let me just record for a little while and then I'll speed up the video in post. Alright, well, that piece of snow at least is gone. And you'll notice it reacted very similarly to frozen CO2. CO2, of course, does this at atmospheric pressure. Whereas the snow I had to bring down to around 4 torr before it would even start to do that. I'm having a lot of trouble keeping the camera in focus. I think it's because of this glass. it's really distorting the image. Oh well. I think you guys have gotten the point. There is something else I want to try though. So let's actually shut this down. Put the air back in. Now, first of all, you'll be able to see the snow melting under atmospheric pressure. And then I want to try putting a thermometer in the snow to see what temperature it actually gets to. Alright, pressure's back on. Oh, you can already see there's liquid water in there. Look how much differently it melts. This is exactly how you'd expect snow to melt. Alright, let's get this switched out for a cup with some snow in the thermometer. So I filled up an insulated flask with some snow, and here's my thermometer. I'm just gonna use my homemade thermometer that uses a multimeter and a coil of copper wire here. So this is measuring the resistance of the coil displayed here in ohms, or degrees Cody, as some people have said. I stick it in the snow. We should see a bit of a temperature drop as it goes down to the freezing point of water. Let me pack all these wires in here so that I can close the door. I wouldn't worry about the multimeter too much. There's really nothing in there that would be affected by the vacuum except for the battery, and I've actually dipped that in some acrylic resin, so... Uh-oh, I did something. Okay, there we go. Was it 100 or 110? If you want to go look at the video, I'll leave a link in the description of me building this. So, temperature is dropping, not by a whole lot. I mean, it isn't very warm in here, so. Anyway, let's close this up and turn on the vacuum. We'll see what the temperature gets to. Alright, so it's been about 40 minutes, and we've got down to 85.2 ohms. I think that corresponds to negative 15 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 26 degrees Celsius. So, yeah, that did get very cold. Theoretically, if I had a perfect vacuum, the water would sublimate all the way down to a temperature of negative 73 degrees Celsius or negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Obviously, this is not a perfect vacuum. In fact, I think you could actually measure the level of vacuum that I have based off of the temperature that the snow got to. So I just repressurized the chamber. Let me stick my finger down in there. That feels very cold. Yeah, it's just normal snow. I didn't really change it any. See the temperature slowly coming back up. Oh, I just shorted something out. Oh well. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Send you. Incendio. Send you.